It's wonderful to be in the house of the Lord. In the presence of God, there is fullness of joy. Also, there is peace. There is peace to your soul and peace to your body. Well, this morning we are going to meditate on Psalm 46. After Psalm 23, Psalm 46 is my favorite psalm. I like very much. A well-known distinguished painter, one day he was conducting a class for the aspirant artist. He was speaking on the subject of artistic composition, and he was emphasizing on the art. If anyone want to be a good artist and want to make a good art of a forest or of a wilderness, then he suggests a artist must make a way out, so that those who look at the art, they may appreciate and find comfort to their souls. My dear brothers and sisters, the Lord has made a way for His people out of all their troubles. Today we live in a very perilous time, very difficult time. The attack on the soldier on the Pulwama, the bomb blast at Sri Lanka church on Easter Sunday, and the terrorist attack in different places. Now we have the Fani cyclonic storm. You might have noticed when you have entered the church building, our cross is broken. In the top of the church building, the cross is broken. And you might have noticed many trees have fallen. Yesterday the ODRAF team came and they cleared all this. And Digal Bhai and ours water tank is blown away. And our AC outdoor unit machine is damaged. Now, no electricity in the city. Of course, we have electricity because the generator is working. In spite of all this, what I want to see is the Lord is good. Praise the Lord. Shall we say praise the Lord again? Praise the Lord. Yes. We have so many difficulties, and some of our brothers and sisters, I heard last night they could not sleep because of the heat, because no fan, no AC, nothing, no electricity. But one thing we can see, the Lord is good to us. The Lord is good, and all the time is good, and He is with us. On 2nd May, a man called from Parala Khemudi, and he said to me, "Sir, is the Lord able to watch over His people?" His second question was, "Is He refuse for His people, or does He abandon us in difficult situation?" I said, "Surely not. The Lord has never abandoned His people. The Lord is a refuge for His people. And this morning the psalmist is reflecting in the very psalm which we have read in Psalm 46. Today we serve a Savior, a God, who is our shelter, who is our salvation, and He is sovereign. This morning, what I would like to do is, let us look into the scripture in this psalm and see three things. Number one, God's shelter. God is our shelter. In chapter 46, verse 1, it says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. The Lord is refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. God is our refuge and strength and help. In this verse, we see three things. Number one, God is our refuge. The word refuge means shelter, hope, or trust. It speaks of safety. In God, we have safety. In God, we have security. In Christ, we are secure. We are secure for eternity. Those who are in Christ, they are secure for eternity. We are sealed by the Holy Spirit. Those sins are forgiven. Those who have accepted Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior, they are secure for eternity. They are sealed forever and ever. Now, in the Old Testament time, when the people of Israel, when they returned to their own land, and God has commanded them to build six city of refuge, three one side and three other side. When someone unintentionally kills somebody, then he must run to the city of refuge before the judgment takes place, before any verdict comes. He must go there and live in that city. That is the only place where he can find a shelter and a security, a safety for his life. But if you read in Numbers 35, you see in the chapter, don't read now. If you read in Numbers 35, now, if a person unintentionally killed a person, murdered a person, now he ran to the city of refuge, as long as he lives in the city of refuge, there is no harm for him, no problem for him. There is a safety for his life. But if he ran away from the boundaries of the city of refuge, now he has a danger. My friend, the Lord is our refuge. The Lord is our safety. Yes, in this world, we have many troubles. We have many problems. But we can seek refuge in the Lord. The Lord is refuge to His people. He will protect us from every trouble. Proverbs chapter 18 verse 10 says, the name of the Lord is a strong tower, the righteous run to it and are safe. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. Now when the storm came, in the first cycle I was in the home, the second time I was in the church. Our Sabhajan bhai and their family, they were inside the church building. Because there was a danger, the mango tree is about to fall. And it has fallen. Now they run, with whole family, they run to the church. Now they are safe. Of course, the mango tree didn't fall on their quarters. My friends, when we face different problems in our life, the Bible says the name of the Lord is a strong tower, and the righteous run to it and are safe. Now, this idea is expressed many times in the Bible. King David always found a refuge in the Lord when he faced the different enemies in his life. The enemies, they tried to kill him, destroy him, but he found refuge in the Lord. In Psalm 18 verse 2 and 3 says, "The Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised, so shall be saved from my enemies." The Lord is my rock and my fortress, my deliverer, my strength. Now, God's people, they have found security, safety in Him. The question is, do you run to the Lord when you have trouble in your life? When we have trouble in our life, we run to different people. We run to different sources. But there is a great source available to us, the Lord's name. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. And secondly, in verse 1, we see the Lord is the strength. Our strength is the Lord. The word strength means power, boldness, to be mighty. When trials and troubles comes, our strength is drained out. Yet at this time, the Lord is able to strengthen us and help us to stand. Many times in your life and in my life, we have experienced, now we are not able to stand again. We are weak, we are about to fall, but the Lord is there to strengthen us. The Lord is able to make us stand. It doesn't matter how strong you are or how weak you are. Sometimes we feel, yes, I'm strong enough, I can stand alone. Sometimes we feel, yeah, well, I am not strong enough, I'm very weak. It doesn't matter. We all need God's strength. My dear brothers and sisters, this morning let me encourage you, we all need God's strength. And the strength of God is available to us. Only He can sustain us in this world. In the trials of life, He is the one who can sustain us. Psalm 73 verse 25 to 26, the psalmist says, "Whom have I in heaven but you? And there is none upon earth that I desire beside you. My flesh and my heart fails, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever." Thirdly, in verse 1, it says, "Very present help in trouble." The third provision that God gives to His people is His help. The word help means to assist. A help given in the times of need. God provides refuge and strength to His people, but He also helps us in our trials. Now, some people, they may extend their help. They may stay away from the people, and from the very distance they may give help. But the Lord is not like that. The Lord is very much near to us. Hebrews chapter 13 verse 5 and 6, you all know. "For He Himself has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. The Lord has promised to his people, he will never leave nor forsake. Storm may come, trials may come, temptation may come, difficulty may come, problems may come, but the Lord says, I will never forsake you, I will never leave you. Now, what prevents us from receiving help from the Lord? All the help is available, all the strength is available to us, but what prevents us to receive this help from the Lord? Two things. Number one, the pride. Number two, fear. Pride keeps us, pride prevents us to receive blessings from the Lord. Pride prevents us to receive God's help. And fear. Are you seeking God's help every day of your life? Will you allow the Lord to take control of your trials and temptations? Will you allow the Lord to take control of your situation? The Lord is waiting to answer your prayer. Our God is a prayer answering God who answers our prayer, who does miracle, who perform miracle in our life. He's a mighty God, almighty God, who perform many, many miracles. Last week, I can testify so many things what the Lord has done to me. He's a miracle working God who listened to the prayer of his people and answers a prayer. In verse 2 and 3, we read, therefore we will not fear, even though the earth be removed and though the mountain be carried into the midst of the sea, though its water roar and be troubled, though the mountain shake with its swelling. In the light of God's provision, how we should respond to uncertainty, trials and conflict? We should respond in faith, not in fear. You might have heard the name Hudson Taylor, a missionary to China. When he first traveled to China by ship, when they are reached to the shore of the island called the cannibal people, where the cannibal people are living, and as they are sailing, suddenly there was no wind in the ship. The ship did not move forward, and the cannibals people are ready to catch the passenger in the ship. Now the captain of the ship came to this missionary Hudson Taylor and said, Mr. Taylor, please pray that God may send wind so that we can move forward. And Hudson Taylor said, I will pray with one condition. If you sail the ship, then only I will pray. Then he said, the captain declined and said, I cannot do that because there is no wind. And finally, Hudson Taylor prevailed, and the captain agreed. He started to drive the ship. Now there was prayer. Hudson Taylor, he prayed, and the ship was moving. And suddenly there was a knock in the Hudson Taylor room in the ship. And it was the voice of the captain. And the captain said, are you still praying? Then Hudson Taylor said, yes. Well, please stop praying because we do not need more wind. We have so much of wind, our ship can sail. My friends, the Lord is our refuge and strength and very present help in trouble. He provides everything. Hudson Taylor responded to this trial with faith, not in fear. Fear comes from the Satan, but faith comes from the Lord. In 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7 it says, "For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of sound mind." And Paul was very much confident. If you read Romans chapter 8 verse 38 to 39, he explained, he is very much confident in every situation. He is putting his faith on Jesus Christ. Second thing we see in this psalm, God's salvation. Verse 4 to 6 we read, "There is a river whose streams shall make a glad the city of God, and a holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. God is in the midst of her, she shall not be moved. God shall help her just at the break of dawn. The nation raised, the kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice, the earth melted." In verse 1 and verse 5, there is a parallel connection. In verse 1, we see God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. But in verse 5, God is in the midst of her, she shall not be moved. God shall help her just at the break of dawn. In verse 1, psalmist says, God is our refuge. In verse 5, he says, God is in the midst of the city of Jerusalem. God makes the city of refuge. His presence brings security. In verse 1, God is our strength. In verse 5, the city will not be moved. In verse 1, he says, God is very present help in the times of trouble. In verse 5, God says, will help her. Now, first time, in the first invention of the king of Assyria, King Sennacherib, when he came to Israel to conquer the land, he came to Jerusalem. He boasted that he will destroy it. But King Hezekiah called upon the Lord. King Hezekiah, he prayed to the Lord. And God protected Jerusalem. God protected Jerusalem from this raging king. The Lord destroyed the Assyrian army miraculously. When God's people pray, God listened to their prayer. My friend, men may plan and they may make many schemes, but sometimes they may be successful, but God has to save the final. In the history we read, Sennacherib, the king of Assyria, he has conquered 10 tribes, the northern kingdom. But when he wanted to conquer the southern kingdom, he failed because King Hezekiah prayed to the Lord. And the testimony that we have in verse 7, this is the testimony of God's people. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. The Bible says the God of hosts is with us. And the God of Jacob is our refuge. There was a missionary couple. They were serving in the islands. One day the people of that area, they wanted to burn down the mission station and to kill the missionaries. One evening in the night, as they plan, they come to near to the mission station with their bow and arrow, and they wanted to burn down the mission station. But when they enter, they saw there are hundreds of people, very tall people. They are having a sword in their hands. They have put a very bright garments. They are speaking very strange language. And these people, the island people, they are not able to, they are not bold enough to go and fight with them. And they run away from that place. After 1 year, the village of that island, the island of the chief of this island, he got converted. And he said to the missionary, last year we came to attack you. We wanted to burn down your mission station. But we saw you have kept so many hundreds of people, a tall people having a torch and sword in their hands, and we are very much terrified and we ran away. Then the missionary said, we are only two people, myself and my wife. There was none. But the chiefs argued with the missionary and said, no, we have seen many people, hundreds of people around your mission station. And finally the missionary understood it was the angels of the Lord who bring salvation to the people. My friends, the Lord protects His people. The Lord, here we see, the psalmist is saying, the Lord is fighting battle for us. Now, many of you may be having apprehension about the election results. On May 23, we are going to know what will be the election results. But one thing we are sure, our Lord brings salvation to us. The Lord is our protector. The Lord is a mighty warrior. We are safe in His protective care. Now this morning, we need to share our testimony with the people. Yes, the Lord of hosts is with us, and the God of Jacob is our refuge. So this morning, what we want to do is, we need to stop worrying and start trusting. Stop worrying and start trusting God. And the third thing which I'd like to mention is God's sovereignty. God is sovereign God. We serve a God who is sovereign. We see His work. 8 and 9. Come and behold the work of the Lord, who has made desolation in the earth, who makes war cease to the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and cut the spear in two. He burns the chariot in the fire. Now this scripture exhorts us and calls us to see the work of the Lord. The people, those who have insight, the people, those who have spiritual eyes, they can see the mighty act of God in their life. The scripture is calling us to see and behold what the Lord is doing. My friends, we need to have the spiritual eyes to see the work of the Lord in our life, because the Lord is sovereign and is a powerful God. Behold the power of God to execute judgment. The psalmist is saying, take a good look at who really is controlling everything. Our God is a sovereign God. He will conquer evil and establish universe. universal peace. Behold the greatness of God's work. And then, if you look to the work of the Lord, it will lead you to worship. In verse 10 and 11, it says, "Be still and know that I am God. I will exalted among the nation. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge." If you see the mighty act of the Lord, if you can behold His act in your life, in your family, in the church, in the nation, then it will lead you to worship. It says, "Be still and know that I am God." To recognize God as the Lord, this was happened in the Mount Carmel. When the Israelites saw the Lord has accepted the sacrifice of Elijah, when the fire came down from heaven and accepted the fire of the altar of Elijah, all the people of Israel, they fell down and worshiped the Lord and said, "The Lord is God. The Lord is God." It led them to worship the Lord. We should stand in awe at the greatness of our God. And we should worship the Lord in the light of who God is and what He has done. Because He is exalted. He has done mighty work in our life. He has done mighty work in our personal life, in our family life. Yes, one of the wonderful things He has done in our life is He has given us salvation. And this morning, we are grateful to God because He is sovereign. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble.